Measurement. Measurement is one of the most important processes in science and in our daily life also. We get up in the morning and get ready for the school nowadays. But somebody asks, at what time do you go to school? Then we will tell, I'll go to school at 7:30. I'll go to school at 8:30. So this is measurement. These questions are related to measurement. How often do you eat fruit? How much you have brought? These questions are related to measurement. So measurement is defined as a way to describe the world with numbers. It answers the questions such as how much, how long, how far. Measurement can be described as the amount of milk in carton, the cost of new compact disc, or the distance between your home and your school. All these things which we generally use, they are related to measurement. In scientific endeavors, it is important that scientists rely on measurements instead of opinions of individuals. You would not know how safe the automobile is if this researcher turned in a report that said vehicle did fairly well in head-on collision when traveling at a moderate speed. So we need to know the exact measurements in certain cases. When we are talking in general terms, he is a bit taller, he is a bit shorter, these can go, but when we are dealing with vehicles or some machines, then exact measurements are needed. Estimations doesn't go there. Estimations are just assumption. As estimation, they can help you make a rough measurement. They can give us about a rough idea about any object, but they can't be exact. Estimation is a skill based on previous experience and is useful when you are in a hurry and exact numbers are not required. But when we are concerned with machines and vehicles, we need exact figures. In many instances, estimation is used on daily basis. For example, a caterer prepares for each night's crowd based on the estimation of how many will order each entry. So, estimations can go well in domestic purposes, in small things. Like, I think he's better than him, he's shorter than him, he's brighter than him, he's fairer than him. These things, they can go with estimation. You can use comparisons to estimate measurements. When you estimate, you often the word about. For example, door knobs are about 1 meter above the floor. A sack of flour has a mass of about 2 kg. It seems it is 2 kg. And I think I can walk up to 5 kilometers. So such estimations can go when we are dealing with not very serious things, which are not very important for measurement. Precision is a description of how close measurements are to each other. Suppose I'm asking you, how long will you take to the school? And you say, I think what is the difference? What is the distance between your school and home? And you say, I think it is 2 kilometers. And when you see the exact measurement, then you find it 1.8 kilometers. Oh, I was near about the exact. That is called precision. The term precision also is used when discussing the number of decimal places a measuring device can measure. So a clock with a second hand is considered more precise than one with only one hand, because it can give us a bit close to exact figures. When it is having two hands, then it gives a close idea, a proximity, close proximity. It leads us very near to accuracy. When you compare a measurement to the real or actual or accepted value, you are describing the accuracy, that it is accurate. If I say, how long is bus stand from here? What is the distance? Then I think it is 2.3 kilometers. And when I see, yes, it is exact this is called accuracy.